your outstretched hands. God, you've been so good to us. You stayed the hand of death and gave us another opportunity to come through these doors and to worship your name. Yeah. We praise you, God, because your name is a strong tower. The righteous run therein, and we are safe, so if today. We're safe, God, because we know you. We're safe because we have your word. We're safe, God, because the Holy Ghost leads and guides us into all truth. So thank you for your safety. Thank you for your guidance. Thank you, God, for covering us. Thank you, God, for protecting us. Thank you, God, for giving us another day. And we've seen danger. But God, you've kept us. You've kept our families. You've kept our children. You've kept us, oh God, even from the big and the power of the enemy. And we thank you for it now. Now here we are, God, here we are. Here we are in a place that I've never been. God, I thank you for this open door that you've allowed me to come to minister to these that have come. This city is in trouble. And God, we need a word. We need a word. We need a rhema word. We need a word to protect us, a word to allow us to see things. And to see things in the better. We thank you for what you're going to do. Now, Father, we thank you for allowing us to connect with such a great body of believers. Thank you, God, for this pastor and this first lady. Father, I pray that you continue to touch this church, the Newell Christian Church, that you would continue to keep your arm and protection around it. This is the day, God, that we celebrate the 23 years of labor, the 23 years of service. That was given, that was built, that was founded upon this great leader. God, I pray that you continue to crown his head with wisdom, knowledge, and understanding how to take this Joshua generation to the next level. You brought us here, this new place, and we thank you because now that we have a new place, we've got new outcome, new perspectives, new things are getting ready to happen. And we thank you, God, for keeping us and covering us and allowing us to see where we are. It is so much better because we've been here. Father, I pray now that you would preach me like a mad woman. Put the devil on the run. Make him drop everything that belongs to the saints in the name of Jesus. And Father, we'll thank you and we'll praise you for it. We'll give you glory, praise, and honor. That the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Oh, the people of the Lord, come on, put your hands together and give God some praise. Come on. Come on, praise God under your mask. Praise him under your mask. Praise him under your mask. Hallelujah. Anybody in here got a praise and you got to get it out? You couldn't get it out at home, so you said, when I get to church, if I enter into his gates with thanksgiving, his courts with praise. I know how to open up my mouth and give God some praise. Nobody has to make me the praise team. Don't have to make me praise God. When I thank him his goodness, everything that he protected me from. Hallelujah. I got so much to thank him for. I truly thank God for this opportunity. Before you take your seat, I want to just reverence this house and certainly this family, the New Oil Christian family. God bless each one of you, but it wouldn't be the New Oil Christian family if it wasn't for a great leader. Come on, let's thank God for this great pastor. Come on, Pastor Carpenter, God bless you, Pastor. I tell you, it's always good to go into new doors, and when you go in new doors, that means new things are getting ready to happen. And as we walked in this door, I asked the young lady, I said, how long have y'all been here? She said, oh, just a year. I said, really? See, y'all don't even know how to act. Has it been a year? Is it a year, Pastor? 2 years? 2 years? It's been 2 years? You still want to get excited. Don't let the newness rub off. Come on, come on. Open up your mouth and let's celebrate. That's why we're here today. Come on. Don't let me Come on, give yourselves a hand for being a part of this great ministry. Certainly, I want to thank God for First Lady. Come on, First Lady Brenda. Come on, now, give us some love. Thank you so much for your hospitality. Appreciate you so much. And certainly, to these great men of God that are here, God bless each of you in your respectful places. More importantly, this is what we call him Uncle. He's Uncle. He's been Uncle a long time. And I tell you, Mr. Clean White, y'all know this man from way back in the day. And he's still relevant for right now. And I tell you, one of the greatest gospel preachers, he's the one that's got tag team. Y'all don't know about no tag team. He's the one that started all of that. This man got 300 and some odd songs that he's written. We got a genius in the house, y'all. Come on, give it up for the bishop, Mr. Clean White. Love you so much, man. You know I love you. You can be seated. Of course, I want to thank God for my daughter. My daughter is here. She came to travel with me. Miss Nakia, it's because of you that I live and I'm not in vain. Hallelujah. Amen. All of you brought the sunshine. All them songs. I'm looking for the miracle. Y'all know that one? It's possible. I feel the intangible. I see the invisible.
Yeah. Just believe.
God confirm what he already said. Now, if you don't say that, let me have that please, I'm not talking to you. But if you really believe what I just said, that's why you got to listen and hear everything that I'm saying, because God is speaking today. I said, how many of you all believe that there is a miracle at your home? And by the time you show up, God's going to confirm it through the mailbox. God's going to confirm it through the FedEx office. God's going to confirm it. Somebody don't speak your neighbor. If you don't know what I'm talking about, you can't get happy about it. But is it anybody here?
Yeah.
Come on, clap your hands for my family. This is my family, number one. brought us from. How many of you can really say that God has spoken in your life through this ministry somewhere, somehow, and it has inspired you in some way? Let me just see your hand. Your life has been inspired through this ministry. That's why we're celebrating today, and I came to celebrate with you these 23 years. I know it has not been easy. It's been many days you didn't want to come. But because of the Spirit of God pushing you here, letting them know that you need to get here to get that word. How many of you know the word changed your life? It changed your life. You keep coming, it'll keep changing. It'll keep changing. I'm a witness of that. So we came to celebrate. I want to go to 1 Chronicles chapter 4. God is sending me this way just to encourage you, just to build your strength. And I want you all to hold on, hold on. I came in this city, walked through the airport. I felt like you all. It's like the Spirit just grabbed a hold of me and said that if God's precious blood is not over us, the enemy would try his best to do damage. But thanks be to God that God kept us. He kept us. So in 1 Chronicles chapter 4, verse 10, familiar passage of scripture, and it says, and Jabez called on the God of Israel, saying, oh, that thou wouldest bless me indeed and enlarge
my territory.
New oil center. Enlarge my coast. And that your hand, thine hand might be with me. And that thou wouldest keep me from evil, that it may not grieve me. And God granted him that which he requested. Are y'all with me? Psalms 138, number of Psalms, and the 7th verse says this. Though I walk in the midst of trouble, thou will revive me. Thou shalt stretch forth thine hand against the wrath of my player haters.
Come on, somebody. Yes.
The Lord will perfect that which concerns me. I got some concerns. But God's gonna fix it. He's gonna fix it. The Lord will perfect that which concerns me. Thy mercy, oh Lord.
I hear you.
I want you to just close your Bible and close your phone. And I just want you to look at somebody with your mask on and tell them, say, in the midst of all this, the Lord kept his hand on me.
Yes.
I want you to look around at somebody else and say, in the midst of all this, the Lord kept his hands on me. Moments, I want to talk about in the midst of all that we are going through here. Because if it's happening here, it's affecting us in Detroit.
Come on.
All over the world, join together in prayer and in the unity of the Spirit of God to continue. In the midst of all of this, one thing we can say, that if it had not been for the Lord, if I start a scripture, y'all supposed to finish.
Come on.
Just believe in good folk talking back to you, especially when they believe in you.
Yes, sir.
If it had not been for the Lord.
Oh, no, my son.
Uh-huh. Yeah. And that's why it's important to make sure that you let everybody know who you are.
Come on, Dr. Cole.
So they know that you're a child of God. They're going to be careful at what they say.
my God.
The grace of
yes.
It's by the grace of God.
Help us, Lord. Help us.
Can you just wave your hand and say, no,
I am still here. Yes.
Remember, you're still here. You know why you're still here? Because God's hand.
She went back in.
It's on. When you really look at this that we've been through for the last couple of months, and I'm so glad that God made changes in the government. Scripture says,
Lord.
Whatever you do, keep your hand on me.
Yes.
Even when it looks like you're going in the wrong way, he will allow you to see that no, you gotta stop. You put up a warning sign so that you can see the right way to go.
Yes.
He'll also help you to make the right decisions.
Mm-hmm.
Help you to inspire you spiritually with your plans and your career and your goals. That's why we come to church. That's why it's important to have a shepherd, because when you have a shepherd, not just have a shepherd, but you gotta pray the time. Not to the shepherd, but you pray the time to God.
Yeah.
And God will. That when COVID came,
Come on. Come on. Close it. Oh my God.
Thank you.
Come on.
In the midst of sorrow, he'll be a peace. Peace in the midst of a storm. Can I get a witness?
Come on.
I stop by and tell him.
Yeah. Nothing for the Lord.